In Exodus 35, Moses has just gathered the Israelites and passed along the detailed materials list from the Lord on building the tabernacle and the Ark of the Covenant and the altar, etc. And he says to gather everything from gold and silver to tent pegs and goat hair. And Moses says to them in verse 5, "Let those with generous hearts present these gifts to the Lord." And then we jump ahead to verse 21, and it says, "All whose hearts were stirred and whose spirits were moved came and brought their sacred offerings to the Lord." Then we see that some brought materials and some brought their skills. But it says in verse 29, they all brought their gifts and gave them freely to the Lord. So about 10 years ago, I was living in Massachusetts, where I was born and raised. And I was at a stage in life where I was wrestling with God, and I was wanting Him to show me His plan for my life. And I was falling into many traps of the enemy and battling with things like anxiety and anger. It seemed like I was getting nowhere with God. So being a prideful, stubborn man, I thought to myself, "I can fix this. I got this." And I began serving more. I took a second job as a building and grounds director at a Christian camp. I was a deacon in my church, volunteering with the youth ministry. I was even taking Bible classes. I thought if I used my skills and abilities and more of my time, that this must be what God wanted. But none of those things brought me answers. They only brought me more questions and frustrations. But then God began to speak to my heart and show me the one thing that a prideful man doesn't want to see. And that was that I needed to submit to Him. You see, through all of this time that I was wrestling with God, I already knew what He was calling me to do. He was calling me to move my family out of Massachusetts. But in my arrogance and my stubbornness, I thought I could please the Lord by sacrificing more of my time and doing all of these things. But all I was really doing was sacrificing my relationship with my wife and my kids. I was reminded of this verse in 1 Samuel 15:22. It says, "But Samuel replied, 'What is more pleasing to the Lord, your burnt offerings and your sacrifices, or your obedience to His voice?' Listen, obedience is better than sacrifice, and submission is better than offering the fat of rams." God didn't need the Israelites' gemstones and goat hair. God didn't need more of my time and skills. He wanted obedience and submission. What is it that you need to do to submit and obey God today? He may have blessed you with many skills and abilities and time, but God doesn't need your sacrifice. He wants your obedience.